In this video, we're going to show you how to draw a cabinet from scratch. Let's get started. Here we're going to start by creating the volume of the area that our piece of furniture is going to be designed within. It's as easy as drawing a box. We'll make it transparent so we can see what we're doing. But now we're ready to start designing our furniture. Here's how. Here we're going to use a special function that allows us just to draw directly off of this volume. We can set the thickness of the board we want and validate. And like that, we're done. Now this time, we're going to take this and we're going to modify that to be hooked to that bottom face. We're going to flip that to be on the inside, plus give it a little bit of a shift. And now that piece is done. Next, we're going to go to a different layer. And we're going to draw yet another piece. And it's going to start off that face and shift from this back face forward. And it's then going to extrude forward for maybe 8 millimeters. And then we'll locate it off this face and shift that down for half as well. Perfect. Now if you look, if we drag this sketch around that created that initial volume, you can see that our parametric design is doing exactly what we had intended. So now we're going to make it a little bit more parametric, and we're going to add some driving dimensions to that initial sketch. And we'll make them symmetric about our zero. Add this one, make it symmetric about our zero as well. And then we'll modify them, set them to some kind of fixed value, as well as name them. So you can see, nothing very difficult here. And like that, those dimensions will be used later to drive the overall width and depth of our design. Now, let's duplicate some of the common boards. We'll just mirror it about the center of the part, that one and that one. Perfect. Let's maybe switch colors and let's add another element. How about the bottom? Perfect again. Now we're going to speed things up a little bit here just to win some time. And basically what we're doing is we're describing each of these parts as wood parts. Okay? And what that means is we're giving them their characteristics, their names, their processing information so that we can process them later. Here we're going to create a little kickboard here. That'll be good for our drawer later on. And again, you're seeing how hard this is. Now, here we're going to include a standard component, and this is kind of cool. Watch, I pick the two points, and boom. Like that, our piece of trim work is just inserted. And what's even cooler is it's going to follow the rest of this design. Here we'll do one across the front as well. And then maybe from there, we want to miter those together. So let's go do that next. We'll miter that to there, and this to this. Perfect. But that looks a little small. Maybe we should see if we can put a bigger one in. So we'll go here and grab a larger code. That looks better. Let's update all of them. Change complete. Let's maybe modify that. Shift it back a little bit so we have a little bit of an overlap. Perfect. We're going to apply a standard solid modeling feature called a fillet. We'll select the edge to apply the fillet to. Like that, we're done. Let's go back to wood now. And let's do something fun. We'll select that edge. We'll select the profile tool that we want to use. And we're done with that too. So again, my point here is that everything we're doing has very simplistic steps, but yet you get a very powerful design out of it at the end. Here we just added another board and we'll add a little relief to that edge. Same thing on that edge. Perfect. We'll add it to wood. We'll give it a name. And that component's finished. Now we're going to add a couple of drillings. And these will be used later for the components that we're going to be inserting. So we'll modify these, get them exactly where we want them. Perfect. And now let's insert another standard component. And here we'll start with the backboard. And what we're going to do here is we're going to select the faces to define everything. This is where we want the backboard to be. We'll validate. We're done. We'll automatically process it. And basically what that means is that adds all the elements that are required for that board to work. You can see them being added there. Now, let's go ahead maybe and modify the width. We're going to test our parametrics right here. It's always a good idea when designing something that's going to be super parametric like this is to try it out and make sure that you've actually captured your true design intent. Looks like we have, so we can move on to the next step. Here, we're going to use our component wizard. And we're going to ask our component wizard to add dowel cams automatically to this design where needed. And we're going to do it based on some specific elements. We're going to select the elements that we want to include this component on. Select a reference face. Choose the inside face. And you can see the software automatically adds everything that's needed to each of these components. Again, how cool is this? Throw it into a perspective view just for fun. And now here, let's add some more components. How about we start with a door? So here what we're going to do is measure from there to there, give it a little clearance, and yes, we're relating this parametrically, and we'll measure again that length plus a little clearance, or I should say minus a little clearance. We'll locate our design. We want a right-hand door, and basically what we want to do is locate it right there. And like that, our door is inserted. We're going to include another one, and while we include it, we're basically going to link its width and height to the first door that we included, and then we're just going to switch from a standard right to a standard left, include it at that position, and we're done. And these standards that we're including, by the way, these can be 100% defined by you, so you can capture your manufacturing process for these doors, for example. Let's go ahead and include our drawer. So here again, we're going to measure dynamically, get the length of that, minus a little clearance, and then we'll also get the, we'll do measurement again, and we'll get the distance from the back there to the front here, again, minus a little bit, and then we'll position this right on the slide there. Perfect. Let's keep going. We're going to add one more component. And this is going to be a dynamic little flap that hides this drawer when you close it. So we'll include it right there. Perfect. And if you want, we can go test this. So here you can see that you would have to manually close that, and that's no fun. So what we're going to do is we're going to create what we call a constraint system set. We'll insert one more constraint between that and that. And now what's going to happen when we move it is it's automatically going to close when we close the drawer. Let's take that a little bit further. Let's add one more constraint, but let's make it a stop. Okay? And this means that that drawer can only be pushed in so far. So when we test our mechanics, everything is perfect. Maybe we want to go to a conical view. And now we're going to include our driving elements. And the reason why we're going to include these driving dimensions, and we can test them again right now, is so that then when we include this assembly that we just drew, live in front of you into another assembly, we can dynamically set it to the sizes that we need right then and there. Very cool. Let's have a look. So here we have a room designed up, and we're going to include this piece of furniture. And basically what we're going to do is we're going to locate it in our design. We're going to take that face to there, and we'll take that face and put it on the wall there. And then just for fun, we'll take that back face to the back wall underneath the stairs, plus the big offset so it sticks out again. And now we've included our design. And like that, we can still test it. We can open the doors if we want, and we can open and close that drawer as well. Very cool. So in a matter of a few minutes, we've captured this design perfectly. We've made a perfect parametric version of this piece of furniture. Just to show you what we mean, just go to Modify Parameter, select it, and you can modify the width, the depth, what have you. Now it's not as wide. Let's maybe make it not as deep either. Perfect. Another example of capturing your manufacturing process with TopSolid.